During the last several years, millions of people around the world have watched the frequent and episodic effusive volcanic eruptions occur on Iceland's Reykjanes Peninsula. But what if I were to tell you that such an eruption could not only occur within a section of the United States, but actually did occur around 11,000 years ago? What I am referring to is the Devil's Garden volcanic field, which in 9000 BCE produced a 3.2-year-long eruption that resulted in 38 square miles being covered in a layer of lava which averaged 40 feet thick. And despite the fact that the vents which fed this eruption will not erupt again, the volcanic field it is a part of is still considered as active. In other words, this little-known volcanic complex may one day erupt again, despite today containing no surface activity such as gas vents or hot springs. So, why exactly did the Devil's Garden volcano, which measures 6.1 miles wide and 10.8 miles long, form? The short answer is the disappearance of regional glaciers after the last glacial maximum 21,000 years ago, combined with the disappearance of a 1,000 square mile Pleistocene lake 15,000 years ago. Both of these features had placed large amounts of strain on the underlying crust, causing it to sink downwards. But once this mass was removed, the crust rebounded upwards, creating numerous faults and weak points for magma to intrude into. As a result, between 20,000 and 9,000, but most notably 12,000 to 9,000 years ago, areas of the world which at one point had glacial cover saw an increase in the rate of volcanic eruptions by as high as 300%. Yet, the volcanism which formed these features indicates that they are not part of the Cascade mountain range, hence their different composition. Instead, they are part of a strange province known as the High Lava Plains, where during the last 15,000 years, repeated large outpourings of lava have occurred from multiple complexes, leading to a cluster of black lava fields so large that they are each visible from orbit. The eruptions in this province were triggered by a quirk on a specific section of a subducting tectonic plate. Although the exact reason why this occurred is unclear, in geologically recent times, a small portion of the Juan de Fuca plate was unexpectedly pulled downwards at a steeper angle. As a result, viscous material in the mantle was quickly forced into the empty space the recently shallower angled plate once held, creating a curved motion that pulled molten rock upwards. Fairly sizable volumes of the molten rock pulled upwards by this action subsequently intruded into the crust, some of which eventually erupted, forming the volcanoes of the High Lava Plains. The Devil's Garden lava field formed around 9000 BCE when a 2 kilometer or 1.24 mile long dike of magma began rising through the crust. A plume of white volcanic gases then started rising from 3 points on the ground until suddenly a fountain of lava shot several hundred feet upwards. As lava erupted, small fragments of gas-rich molten rock thrown into the air fell back to the ground largely within a 400-foot radius, building a small ash-poor volcanic cone known as a spatter cone. Eventually, the southern two spatter cones became inactive after growing to 62 feet in height. As lava flows expanded outwards, their motion was both aided by gravity as they were pulled downslope, while also blocked by higher pre-existing terrain. Eventually, the turbulence related to the main active channel crusted over, forming a lava tube. This lava tube, which is today the site of the 1/4 mile long Dera cave, is what more than 90% of all lava at this volcano flowed through at one point. Supplying lava to more distant locations while maintaining a high temperature, lava continued onwards, flowing up to 12 miles away. What started as stronger eruptive activity slowly declined over time, eventually becoming intermittent before stopping altogether. In total, 1.2 cubic kilometers of lava was emplaced. Due to the fact that this volcanic field's recent eruptions were all effusive or only moderately explosive, its low eruptive rate, and the fact that very few major points of infrastructure exist nearby which could be threatened by a future eruption, Devil's Garden does not rank among the nation's most dangerous volcanoes. As a result of these hazards, the U.S. Geological Survey designated Devil's Garden as a very low-threat volcano. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.